Hello everyone. In this video we are going to be talking about the properties of angles. To do that we are going to need the knowledge of parallel and transversal line. So let's consider these two parallel lines. Okay, so here are the lines. The arrows that put hands here shows that they are lines and not just line segments. So, and these red arrows show that the two lines are parallel. So to denote the parallelism, would say that AB, so I'm going to use red here, so these two strokes denote parallelism. So this means that AB is parallel to CD. Now the next thing is going to be to introduce a transversal line. So I'm going to label the angles in lowercase, so we can see an angle here. I'm going to label that A. The one on the right here, B. The angle here, C. This is D. This one right here, E, F, G, and H. So this transversal and the parallel lines have produced 8 angles. Now, we've got a number of implications when a transversal runs across 2 or more parallel lines. There are a number of implications. Okay, here they are. So this is the first implication. Vertical angles are equal. The second one, corresponding angles are equal. The third implication is that alternate interior angles would be equal to each other. So we need to identify each of these three angles. The first is the vertical angles. Vertical angles are angles that are about the same point but are opposite to each other. So looking at this diagram here, we would see that there are 4 angles clustering around a point, but A and C are opposites, so we would say that A is equal to C. So A is equal to C, vertical angles. Similarly, B is opposite D. So B is going to be equal to D. To the bottom, we would see that E is also going to be equal to G. And finally, F is going to be equal to H. So going back to the diagram, we would realize that angle A is going to be corresponding to angle E. Because A is formed between an intersection that looks like this, and E is also formed between an intersection that looks just like A. So we would say that angle A is equal to E. Now, we can apply the same arguments to B and F. B is formed between an intersection that looks like this and also F is also formed between a similar intersection, so we would say that angle B is equal to angle F. The same arguments can be deployed for D and H and C and G. So D is going to be equal to H and C is going to be equal to G. So these are the corresponding angles. Okay, back to our diagram. Two angles are alternate if they are within two parallel lines on opposite sides of the transversal. One is going to be at the top, the other is going to be at the bottom, going by this diagram here. So looking at that, we would see that the angles A, B, G, and H do not make the cut because the angles A and B are at the top, while the angles G and H are at the bottom of the parallel line. So we've got just these 4 angles here, C, D, E, F. There can be alternates. So the second condition, being on opposite sides of the transversal, we would see that C is going to be alternate to E. So C is equal to E, alternate interior angles. And also, F is going to be equal to D. F is equal to D. The next thing we are going to do here is to apply these principles to solve a problem. Please come with me. Here is the problem. Triangle ABC is isosceles. AC is parallel to BD. Find the value of A and the value of B. Here is the diagram. So we've been told that triangle ABC is isosceles. This is triangle ABC. So since it's an isosceles triangle, we know from properties of an isosceles triangle that two sides are equal and two angles are equal. So how do we identify the two angles that are equal in an isosceles triangle? The angles are the base angles. So the base angles are equal. So in order to identify the base angles, all we just need to do is to isolate the angle that's included in the two equal sides. So here, AC is equal to CB. So the angle at C is the included angle. So that leaves us with the angle at A and this angle right here, the angle ABC here. So these two angles will be the equal angles because they are the base angles. So these two angles are equal. So since the angle ABC is lowercase a, I can just write a lowercase a here because they are the same. And of course, we know that from the sum of angles in the triangle, we can add up these three interior angles in the triangle and equate to 180 degrees. The reason is very obvious. The sum of angles in the triangle is 180 degrees. So solving this equation, a plus a is 2a. So I'm just going to move 40 degrees to the other side. That's going to give 180 minus 40. So this is 2a equals 140. Dividing both sides by 2 here, I'm going to have a equals 140 over 2. And a is going to give 70 degrees. So I'm just going to put 70 here. 70 degrees. Next is going to be to obtain the value of angle B. So we are going to be needing this information here. The fact that lines AC and BD are parallel. And we can see it here. This arrow is the symbol for parallelism. So clearly we can see that the line AC is parallel to line BD. So since these two lines are parallel, that makes the line BC a transversal line. So this line BC serves as a transversal because a transversal line is a line that's drawn across two or more parallel lines. And what happens when a transversal line cuts across parallel lines? Alternate angles are equal, corresponding angles are equal, vertical angles are equal. So in order for us to obtain the value of angle B, we are going to be needing those implications. Now, which one do we think is going to be more relevant to us? Looking at the diagram closely, we would see that the angle BAC, the angle at A here, is formed between is an intersection that's similar to the angle that's formed right here. Now, let's look at that. Now, the angle at A here, angle BAC, is formed between an intersection that looks like this. So this is it. And the angle here, we can also see that the intersection looks just like the intersection that has angle A. So this angle here is going to be equal to angle A. So I'm just going to write A. And since A is 70 degrees, so it means this angle here is 70 degrees. We can see that the angle at B has been partitioned into three. It looks somewhat like this. The angle on the left is A, which is 70 degrees. B is unknown. And the angle on the right is A, which is 70 degrees. So all three angles are on a straight line. And since the sum of angles on the straight line is 180 degrees, so it means if I add up all three angles, 70, B, and the one on the right, which is 70, I'm going to get 180 degrees. That's the sum of angles on the straight line. So solving this equation, I'm going to have B plus 70 plus 70 is 140. So to equal to 1 AB. Taking 140 to the other side, so B is equal to 40 degrees. So I'm just going to include the 40 here. This is 40 degrees.
I hope you found this video useful. If you did, kindly like, subscribe, and share it. Thank you for watching. See you in the next video. Bye.